Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Let's continue the discussion regarding robot singularities. Let's get started. In the last video, we mainly talked about wrist singularities. In this one, let's talk about shoulder singularity. So to explain this one, I will bring in this object, shoulder singularity plane. The shoulder singularity occurs when the wrist, which is where joint 5 and joint 6 cross, is on the plane here, on this plane, and this plane is a plane that is simply aligned with the axis of joint 1. So if I bring in robot panel, I can here activate joint 5 reference frame, so you can see it here, and in this case where joint 5 is also where joint 6 cross, so both are at the same spot. So if I go here and I'm going to bring it here. No, I need to activate the other tool. So here, and I don't need to see this TCP here. And I can see here this one. Okay, cool. So here you can see that the wrist or joint 5 is directly on this shoulder plane. So I created this kind of imaginary plane to help you understand where the shoulder singularity occurs. And if I run the shoulder singularity infinite, you will see again, it's a situation where we have an infinite number of answer to a single TCP position or a single tool position. So it kind of creates the same problem as we saw with the wrist singularity. So if I was to run the shoulder singularity here, I need to remove the robot welding gun in this case. I don't want to see it. It's the flange that is important. I created it with the flange. Here, directly where, when we reach kind of the axis of joint 1, we say here robot is too close to front back singularity. So it's another name we give to wrist singularity, front back singularity. Wrist too close to axis 1, so it simply doesn't work. In your case, if you run this one, you might not see any singularity issue. You might not see any warning. This is because by default, under tools motion tolerance to avoid front back singularity, there is a -1 written here. -1 means that RoboDK won't check for singularities at all. So if you just enter 2.5 here, it should be enough to make it work. In the same way as the wrist singularity was causing joint 4 and joint 6 to rotate in opposite direction, here it forces joint 1 and a series of other joints to rotate really quickly in different directions. So if I run here Kuka no shoulder singularity, I should have almost named it like near shoulder singularities. You would have saw here, you see that we have a quick rotation of the wrist to be able to kind of compensate for that linear motion here. So again, you might experience a slowdown of the speed of your robot in real life, depending on what linear speed you are actually requesting. Here, if you open the folders, you will see that I have a YouTube link here. In this case, it's 07Y Industrial Robot Singularities. And this will bring a video of Mechademic, one of our partner here, where they explain or they showcase singularities in very easy way. So here we have the wrist singularity, exactly what I showed you. So we have an infinite amount of solution for one given pause. Then here, if we go close to singularity, you'll see exactly what I was explaining. It's like, as we go close to singularity, the robot is forced to reduce its speed because it reaches the maximum speed of one, or the slowest joint between joint 4 and joint 6. So by the time it has kind of finished its full rotation, now it can pick up and go back for the seat. We didn't talk much about elbow singularities because it's often time easy to fix. It's just like you're almost out of reach. The robot is fully extended. So I would say that I'm not generally explaining this one as a singularity, even if it's one. I'm just saying like, you're almost out of reach, like kind of figure out a way to bring things a bit closer to the robot base, and it will help in whatever situation you are stuck in. And then you have the shoulder singularity, where here, as I explained to you, you have an infinite amount of solution when joint, the axis of joint 5 and the axis of joint 6 crosses where the axis of joint 1 is. So if you were to create an imaginary line along the axis of joint 1, it would cross the line where joint 5 are. And this, therefore, you have an infinite amount of solution for a given pause. Same as for the wrist singularity. If you go close to the singularity, you will see a slowdown of the TCP because you will go at the speed of the slowest joint in the set here. Cool. So, and I'm going to go back to RoboDK. I will open here. I will show the UR5 robot. Collaborative robots are a bit different in terms of how they're built. They still have singularities related to the wrist. So the wrist singularities occur when joint 5 is either at 0 or 180 or minus 180. So if when it's at in a singularity, that means that both of those joints here. Oops. No, I'm gonna bring it back to home. Sorry. You are in a singularity if joint 5 is at 0, 180, because joint 4 and joint 6 are parallel. They are not aligned, but those the axes are parallel. So it causes kind of the same type of problems. And if I run this here, you will have the same problem. So here for collaborative robot, it's a bit more tricky for us. So we're not necessarily like telling you which singularity you're hitting, but it's just telling you that there is no solution for the available path to be completed. And then you also have the shoulder singularity that occurs here, and this one is again when the wrist is along the plane. So if I run this one here, and you are stuck here, and it's telling you there is no solution available for to complete the path. There's two ways, by the way, with RoboDK to figure out if you are hitting a singularity or not. The first one is to just try to run the program. The other solution is to right click, and then here you have check path, and it will tell you here in this case, path fail at a given move L. You have shoulder singularity 2. Okay, so this is the name of the path here. You have a UR shoulder singularity program move L instruction 4. It's unreachable or undoable, in fact. If you go check pad here, same for this one here. If I go for the wrist one, I can close that here so it'll help me. Check pad here. This one is impossible, not reachable or singularity or something like that. And here, if I look for one that is doable, it will tell me like no problem found with this pad. So I can evaluate the pad without having to completely run it. So that might be faster if you just want to evaluate one path. So before we leave, I'm just going to show you what happens with Cobots when it comes to singularities. So by the way, this is where I did my study. So ETS and Cobot, this is where I also teach in university as a lecturer. Here, this is a lab of robotic precision. So here, if you have a wrist singularity with UR robot, or with Cobots in general and their kinematic, it will give you that. There's a specific sound when you go near a singularity with robots. You will have a wham, and this is generally because you hear, see here, this is what happened when you hit the singularity, they kind of error out. And yeah, you will have a specific sound with robots when they are close to singularity. If you hear it once, you know what I'm talking about. It's kind of a wham. You see like the winding of the joint. This is because like the joint is kind of ramping up its speed very quickly. And it's not very good for the robot itself. Like let's say that you won't increase the life, the possible life of your robot if you're always going through singularities or near singularities, in fact, because you can't go through those, but near you can. So shoulder singularity here, this is what will occur. And here you have the elbow singularity, which is pretty much just a limit more than anything. But here, the important thing again is like exactly the same as for industrial robot, you will have a slowdown when you go near of a singularity, either the shoulder or the wrist one. So if you can try to avoid it, it's better for your robot. It's better for your general efficiency in terms of cycle time. If you can, if you need to go close to a singularity, you just can, you can simply use a joint motion. That will also work perfectly. So that's pretty much everything for this video. I hope it was helpful. This is a topic that I think needs to be discussed and is not necessarily understood properly by everyone in the field of robotics. Like, so I do believe that this one can be very helpful for many of the users. In the next video, we will talk about rounding or continuous path or blending or continuous motion. So how to make sure that you have a path that is fluid and how this is handled by the controller and how this is handled within RoboDK. I hope to see you there. And in any case, have a great day, guys. Thank you.